Great news, everyone! This is Elite Dangerous, and I figured out how to use the debug camera. As you can see, it's with the joystick. That is my ship. Isn't it pretty? It's just so beautiful. You gotta love that, right? Woo! The camera is a little bit difficult to learn to use. We're going to do a little zoom around. I found out the hat switch for your like up, down, left, right thrusters moves it like that. Twist the throttle, forward, back, rotate, and then the throttle is, oops, I'm hitting stuff, the forward and back. There's my sexy Vapor Mark 4 right there. Isn't she pretty? But we're in the station right here. Let's go into Starport Services. I should probably refuel this. There we go. Let's check out the mission board. Let's see what we have here. We're only doing missions with the people aligned with the Federation. Got these things right here, little emblems that tell you who you're aligned with. So we click on them, because I want to raise my standing with the Federation, so we're going to be using these. Let's see if there's any Navy. Ooh! Yes! That is exactly what I was looking for. Let's see, deliver data to this place in. That system, be stored in your computer, will not require any cargo space. You receive your reward upon delivery. Good luck, Commander Weevil. Plan your journey, blah, blah, blah. Higher ranked missions are offered as your reputation increases. These come with higher rewards. Medium, medium, medium. It doesn't say, hostile ships may be sent against you. It doesn't, yeah, it's not a list of goods. Or anything of that. It's probably going to be a bit of a destination away, right? However, if I can complete this, I should go up a rank with the Federation. And this is what I've been trying to do this whole time. Let's do it the easy way. Let's go to transactions, look on the old map. This should bring it up. There we are. We're just going to buy the data for 58 credits, and we're gonna go into the system, and well, holy crap, look at that. It's just one planet with a little star base. Not star base, outpost, platform, whatever you want to call them. I can't remember what they're called right now. Okay, and that is one jump, really? Well, yay for me. Let's return to the good old service so we can take a look around before departing this fine station. I was playing this last night and I bumped into a ship. The AI is not very smart. Someone's taken off over there. The AI is not very smart when it comes to keeping from hitting you. It's not that great at collision detection. So someone's taken off. Let's just wait for them. Oh, someone entering. Yep, it was that ship entering, so we should be good to launch. God, I hope I don't hit anybody. Okay, oh, a little bit too far. I got a little overzealous. Injure down. I love that sound that force field makes. It sounds like America. Okay.
Moderate traffic around the station.
And The planet is blue for once. Nice. Oh, screwed that up.
Flight assist on.
First thing I'm going to do is I'm going to go in and remove the orb blinds because I don't like them. They are very handy, but I do not like them. I like the immersion of not... Why thank you, station. I don't like the orbital lines, because it takes away from the immersion for me, basically, so... Whoa! You gotta remember that these are technically loading screens, so every once in a while it will do that. This is a Navy mission, however, I am not hostile in this system, so I should be okay. I might come across a pirate, and if we do, I'll just submit to the interdiction unless I'm right there ready to drop out a super cruise, and we'll blow them to hell, assuming I can. Most NPC ships that are sent against me in this Viper Mark IV, which is a heavy assault fighter, technically, although I have it rigged up to haul lots of cargo because I've been doing a lot of space trucking. It does hold its own. It's the first ship I've had that I kept for more than a day or two. It's like a mid-level. Once I get the Sol permit, and I set up base there, I want to get a light fighter just to play around in. That'll be my little chibi. And then after that, I'm just going to grind for something better, maybe an Asp Scout, just so I can explore with it. It does everything better than this does. But this is the first ship that I have that I plan on keeping, so... It is a nice, versatile, little all-around ship. Plus, I have easily ten times the money into outrigging this ship that I made for it. Okay, interdiction. Nope, I want to submit. Who do we have? Oh, it's just a little fighter. This is actually the fighter that I want to get. And I actually forgot to put pips to my... There we go. Okay, there we go. Here's my chance. And I'm getting really creative with the throttle inputs here. Oh, the little bitch is running. He's running. Too late. Ooh. And I took more damage hitting that debris than I did. Well, I didn't take any damage to my shields. I'm not going to bother with the, picking up any of this loot, because I want to get to my intended destination. But there we go. That was some fighting right there.
Cannot comply.
I thought I retracted my hard points. Okay, here we go. That button is the button I have mapped to the joystick. I don't have it on my keyboard anywhere. I should change that. 3, 2, 1, engage. See what I was talking about? This is a very good ship for this type of stuff. If I was in open play, that could have been a player, and it could have been a much bigger ship, and I could have been easily screwed. So, assuming none of my audio recording or video recording fails, I am recording properly. I am recording my voice on a separate. I'm recording my voice using a separate program than my video capture software. I did not do that on the last video, and that is why the audio was, for lack of a better word, a bit shitty, and I also was not in my little captain's character. I was up late drinking. Oh crap! That's what I get for looking at the other monitor, watching my audio recorder go. And I am also wearing earbuds. I do have a recording headset somewhere. I do not know where it is right now, so there's the planet just above us. That's actually a really nice view. We should be just far enough away that the mass of the planet does not slow me down, which it isn't. And we should be coming in to our drop point in just a few seconds. Our speed is good. We are just waiting on the distance. And a big blue warning will pop up on the screen to let me know, so I don't really need to be watching that. There we go. Okay, we have entered the no-fire zone, so I'm going to throttle back to zero. Request docking.
Docking request granted.
Pad 1, which is right there, and from this distance it is hard to see if I'm coming from the right angle or not, but yes I am. That is a nice change of pace. And if you ever notice that I employ silent running when I'm docked, I only do that to cut down on engine noise in the station. Plus, it makes me feel like I'm doing something. I wouldn't recommend doing that unless you're a kind of a role player, do it for immersion as I do. Because if you forget to turn that back on, you will on dock, you will launch, and you'll wonder why your ship's about to explode. Because once we're outside the station, the ship will start to get very hot. Okay, starport services. Ooh, I love these Federal Navy jobs. Let's see, was that enough? I do not care for that. Federal Navy promotion to cadet. Good job, Commander Weevil. The Federation Navy has promoted you to the rank of cadet. Why, thank you. Ooh, I actually have to do some grinding now. Yes, my ship is current assets over 4 bill, almost 5 bill. And you can see what I spent on outfitting. what do I have? Do I have a permit yet? I keep hitting the wrong button. No permits. I do not remember. I think it's midshipman that I have to get to. So what we are going to do is go into our bookmarks. Oh, that's what I did last video. I bookmarked the... I bookmarked the station instead of piloting a route to it. There we go. And I'm not really in the mood for this, nor do I know why I'm being interdicted right now. Let's see if I can get... Oh, shit. Whoa, this is a tough one. This feels almost like a player interdiction right here. There we go. I'm not 100% sure what that was about. If it happens again, I will drop out and I will fight them, but we have better things to do right now, my space friends, so we are going to head back to Han Gateway. I don't do all of my business out of Han, but what... I was going to do a Dos Equis joke, but this is what I prefer to use as my interim home station until I get to Earth. I also don't know if basing myself out of Seoul is the best idea. Solo play, it probably does not matter much. Online, And if I ever do want to do online play, I'll be guaranteed to see plenty of players. Although they will only be players, there won't be any new players either. That's the thing. Won't be anybody to screw with. Although I'm not that type of guy anyway, so. And there's the infamous wedding barge there, passengers. I still haven't written my vows. What can I say? Why are you broadcasting this to local? This sounds like a private conversation there, Mr. Groom. It's a nice little filler, but I would rather they stuck with people bitching at the cops for scanning them, because that's the same conversation that you... Whoa! Look at that. That you always hear, right? And I'm not 100% sure why.
Echo. Follow all federal docking protocols before attempting to dock.
Let's drop this down. Under 100. There we go. Am I close enough? Yes.
Authorization cleared. Proceed to landing pad 3-6.
They should really have a docking radar, because this radar right here is not very useful.
This is a speed-restricted zone. Throttle down immediately.
Yes, I am aware. See, what happens is, although my throttle's set at 77, when I do my lateral thrusters and stuff to go up and down, it shows on your speed, and that's very hard to control. That's just a tap switch I'm using for that. Let's see, 36. Where is 36? Should be over here. There we go. Oops. Are my lights on?
Landing gear deployed.
This station operates under a docking reservation policy. Ensure you have authorization before attempting to disembark.
Oh, I know. I made that mistake when I was new. I just flew right into the station, didn't realize I had to ask for permission, and I got shot. Just accept all these boom deliveries.
Unsanctioned acts of aggression will not be tolerated.
Man, that is a pretty view. Look at that. That is just beautiful. Hell, this should be my home station just because of that. But it's not. I don't know why it spins us around on these outposts, but it does. I can understand a regular station, but these outposts, I don't see the point. It'll probably be right before I'm ready to drop out of Super Cruise. That's usually... Yep. Let's just submit. Always forget to put pips to my weapons. I had the fire group up and everything, but I always forget to do the weapons. If you haven't realized, my gimbaled lasers are my secondaries that I'm shooting right now, and I have my regular lasers on the fire. Okay, what's this? Looks like it's the last of them. Good. And again, I'm not going to waste my time. Normally, if I'm not recording, I will scoop those, but I don't want to waste my time doing that. Sure, I retracted those.
Frameshift drive charging.
Let's see, you're mine now. Empty your cargo hold and everything will be fine. Now you die, victim. Well, I guess he was wrong. Just point it right at the center. Thinking Mawu, whatever that is, over to Ross, down to this LP-88 and Bast, and then probably back.
Copy.
You see all these lights. Those are all solar systems. Just fill up my vape. My pretty pink vape. Oh shit. I just realized I am low on fuel.
Landing gear retracted.
I did not bother to refuel at that station, so you know what? We're probably just going to do a fuel scoop at the next star.
Frameshift drive charging. 4, 3, 2, 1, engage.
No, I should be able to get fuel from it. No. Well, let's try. Let's see what happens. Normally, these bright stars, you don't get fuel from because they're so hot. I'm actually used to. I'm going to have to do that. No, let's learn to do it without it. I'm used to fuel scooping with orbital lines turned on. I'm used to using that as a cue. I've never done it yet. I think I might have to wait till I get to a yellow star. This white one, I think, is going to be too big of a pain in the ass. Not dark stars, there we go. I need that little yellow line in order to fuel scoop.
Fuel scooping.
And there we go, we're full.
Fuel scoop disengaged.
Turn them back off. I scanned the system with my scanner, so now it should show up. There we go. Apparently I'm out of range to figure out. I know there's a station there, but I don't know what it's orbiting them, which is a little strange. And that's the star that we were just orbiting. That's how far away we got in that short amount of time. If I was playing this game in a way where I didn't have destinations set the entire time, and I was exploring, or looking for someone, or something of that matter, I would have to have orbital lines turned on. But since I always know where I'm going, at least as of right now, I keep them off because I like the way the game looks without them. We cannot dock from this angle, so we gotta do a little circle here.
Void.
Damn, that ship is close to me. My destination is on the other side of the star. We did have one thing discovered, so we're gonna pulse our discovery scanner. And 19 new. And you can sell that data.
Disengaged.
That is part of exploration. The other part is actually flying around the system and scanning all the stuff in it. And there is one of the stars you cannot fuel scoop from, and it is way hotter than it looks. Let's pulse the scanner quick right before we jump, just to see if I get anything. Nope. I must have been here before. We do have pulsars, and those are crazy. You want to stay away from them. I believe there's a way to super charge your frameshift drive, which is your jump drive, if you do it properly. But I do not know how to do that. So, and this is one of the ones where we're going to land on a planet. Yes, this is not right. The game is being strange. I'm not sure what's happening here. That is weird. I must have locked the wrong thing. Okay, that'll happen. Guess that the entrance is on this side, so I'm going to guess that. These stations are always fun. They're always hard to find the entrance to, although I'm getting much better at it. This is pretty. Oh shit. Almost overshot the pad. Oop. Bounced. Clear, clear. I hear something close, though. Let's just launch. Whoa, that's what I heard. Always gotta love those Russians. It's like Commander Chekhov voice. That is going to be a very bright star. Oh, bright yellow. Another blue planet.
hunting gear deployed.
Stalk onto all vessels. If you are unable to complete docking procedure within your time slot, you will need to exit the bay and submit a new docking request.
And touchdown. Just like every other time, we refuel, go into the mission board, turn it in. Exit, open up the map. Crap, we're gonna drop out on this star, and we're going to have to fly all the way to this one. That is going to be a trip. Is a pretty view. Circle it around so we can see it.
Four, three, two, one, engage.
I don't know if we went through that planet or how that works, but. And now for the serious space trucking. You can see how far away it is. One day at this moment. As our speed goes up, it will start going down. But this is going to be a very long trip to this third star. Thank you. Okay, we came out of warp. Three new astronomical objects found. Let's do a D-scan. 20 new astronomical objects found. Let's go onto the map. Thank God, it is a single star. And we are going to have to land on a moon? Or a planet? It's a moon. I don't know why it keeps doing that. Is still coming up as unexplored. There's a beluga up there. Those are kind of neat. Those are the new starliners. Keeping it in frame just so you can see it. It's going to be landing on pad 4-1 over there. Oops, I was looking at the ship.
Landing gear deployed.
It's landing.
Scan detected.
So what we are going to do is, we are going to climb.
Resume own navigation. Safe trip, Commander.
Because the direction of the next solar system is below the horizon, so we have to supercruise out. Whole bunch of ships. Ooh, flew by him. Whole bunch of ships in front of us right now. Cruise ship, we will be cruising in system for a while. Please feel free to take advantage of our in-flight entertainment. Okay, why would you broadcast that to the system? Services are down. That must be a power play thing. Okay, everything's turned in. We just gotta head back to our home base. fly S-Mart. We're gonna boost out the door, which you're not really supposed to do, but I do it anyway. Oh, and I do have bounties to turn in, which I forgot about, for killing those pirates. I will do that at a later date, if they do not expire. It's not a lot of credits, so I'm not going to worry too much about it right now. I just want to get home. I've been flying for a couple hours. I want to get this done. Three. Oh, this is going to be close. That is something I need to test. See if go full speed at something and see if it forces me out of Super Cruise or just lets me smack into it. I do know you can... I believe it can if you're going fast enough. I took some hull damage. Still taking some heat damage. There we go. I do know that if I were away from the keyboard there, I would have died. Crap. Oh, someone's about to pass me. I can hear them. There we go, Sidewinder or something. Okay, pad 1-6.
Landing completed. Power down system. Station facilities are at your disposal, Commander.
And that is a long haul run for space trucking, aka hauling in Elite Dangerous. That is what I have been doing this whole damn time. There's my little shippy. It's been fun. It's been a long night. It's about time for bed. I'm going to be doing this a bit, trying to get my standing up. I'm probably going to get bored, maybe mix it up. I'll show you if I do. But until then, fly safe, and I will see you all on the flip side. Good night, everybody.